Switch is an automation tool for both OS X and Windows that can automate a whole host of repetitive tasks that are quite often still done manually. Switch is built in a modular format around a core engine and a number of modules that extend its functionality. This movie focuses exclusively on the Switch core engine. It illustrates the different strategies Switch offers to create automated tasks in an intelligent and flexible manner. But it is important to realize that by adding other modules, this intelligence and flexibility can be greatly enhanced. Automating a task starts with building a flow in the Switch Designer application. You drag the elements you need onto the canvas. You configure them, and you connect them in the way you want the job to flow. When you are done, you activate the flow, and it will then run unattended in the background. You can have as many flows active at the same time as you require. Any flow, by definition, will start with an input. On the input side in Switch, this can be one or more simple hot folders, one or more hot folder structures, here referred to as hierarchies, one or more FTP sites, and one or more mail accounts. For each of these, you can set the interval that Switch will check for new files. In the case of mail, it is the attachments that will be processed. It is a common requirement that the processing of a flow is limited to a certain time window. For example, all the jobs that have been queuing up in the input folder have to be released once a day at 4 p.m. This can be configured both at the level of the flow and at the level of the individual inputs. A very important part of the processing of a file is making sure it follows the correct route, and you need some very flexible tools for that. You may, for example, want Word files to be processed differently than PDF files. This is done by creating two connections that have different file type properties, one for Word files and one for PDF files. But you can take it further. You may have to distinguish between files that follow a naming convention and files that do not. In this example, files that start with a 6-digit job number follow one connection, and all other files follow a different connection. This case is solved with the use of a regular expression. But it doesn't stop there. When using the condition with variables property of a connection, you can do some really amazing things. As you can see, you have access to quite a lot of information about the incoming jobs. This job was received through mail, and you can see who sent it. You can see the vital statistics of the PDF file, and so on. More importantly, you can use all of that information to route the job. You can also combine these conditions and route a PDF job based on, let's say, the fact that it came from an Enfocus.com email address, that it is the size of a business card, and that it contains 2 pages. Incoming jobs that are compressed, for example, zip or RAR files, can be uncompressed, and inversely, before sending a job out, it can be compressed. Jobs can be renamed in very elaborate ways. Just to give you an idea of what can be done, here is an example of a PDF file being prefixed with today's date and suffixed with the number of pages in the file. Another straightforward type of processing is the splitting and merging of PDF files. You can split PDF files into groups of pages in a folder. The Job Dismantler tool is there to take the individual PDF files out of the folder, and here is the result. Merging PDF files is often done in combination with another powerful tool in the Switch toolbox, Assemble Job. Here you can specify different schemes to combine incoming PDF files, for example, every 10 files. When PitStop Server is installed on the same computer as the Switch server, Switch will automatically detect this and offer a configurator to process PDF files with PitStop Server. The PitStop Server configurator has properties to set all the different processing options, the preflight profile to use, the action lists that have to be run, the type of language of the report that has to be generated, and many more. On the outgoing end of the pit stop server configurator, Switch will send the jobs along different routes depending on the pre-flight status. And it also has different connections for the pre-flighted file and for the report, so these can be handled in a different way, as in this example, where in the case of a successful pre-flight only, the pre-flighted file is sent on, and where in the case of an error, the report is being emailed. And of course, all flows will end with some sort of output. The job is often handed off into a single folder that is the input for another process. The job can also be moved into a hierarchical folder structure. You can define what that structure will look like, and Switch will create the structure as jobs are passing through. Here is the configuration for putting a pre-flighted file into a structure that looks like this. At the top, there is the domain name of the mail address from which the job was received. Then comes a folder with the date, and in that folder, we will eventually get the job that pre-flighted without errors. When there was an error in the pre-flight, the structure is different in the sense that now there is an additional level at the top, error that contains both the pre-flighted file and the report. And here we see the process at work. A job comes in from a mail account, and after processing, it is in the folder structure as previously defined. Jobs can also be mailed and sent to FTP sites. The mail addresses and the body of the mail can be filled with all sorts of variables to make this completely flexible. And for the paths on the FTP server, the same is true. Switch has some very powerful tools to influence the behavior of jobs on the way out. A common case is that there are several identical outputs, for example, several printers of the same type, and that the output has to be load balanced. This is done by putting a hold element in front of the different outputs, and Switch will distribute the jobs over the different outputs. This can be a simple round robin, but the distribution can also be more intricate and more efficient by taking into account the number of files that are queuing up in the different outputs. This element can also be used to create a time window for outputs just like for inputs. Another tool is the assemble job element that I already mentioned in the context of the merging of PDF files. It is often a requirement that jobs are held until a sufficient number is available for effective processing by the next step in the production flow. You do not process business cards one by one, but in batches of 30, for example. Sending files to a remote production site may be done only once every hour. There are many other variations in place in existing Switch environments. Let me finalize by repeating that this is just the beginning. Adding one of the other modules increases Switch's capabilities in all areas, but more on that in the movies on each of the other modules.